Following the purchase of the machine, I have had three motors. Two of these were under warranty, and the third one, the supplier asked that I pay £400 for a replacement, which I thought this was rather expensive, therefore I would look for an alternative. Initially, I started to review the manual to see if I could find any information on the motor, which was quite limited. What I had to do is refer back to the nameplate on the motor. This is a standard motor supplied with the lathe. It's a 240 volt single phase, four pole, 1400 RPM motor that is 0.55 kilowatts. Obviously, I wasn't going to pay £400 for a replacement, therefore I picked up information from the nameplate on the motor. I was struggling for the frame size. At the end of the day, I thought, well, I'm not going to pay £400. What I'll do, I'll upgrade this motor. Therefore, I looked around on the internet for a suitable motor that'd fit. The motor displayed in this photograph is the closest fit that I could find to the existing motor. It is a 240 volt single phase, four pole, 1400 RPM. So I had that fitted perfectly. The upgrade was 0.75 kilowatt or one horsepower motor. So it would be a more powerful motor. The only problem was is the face mounting was slightly different. So therefore I would have to remove the existing face mounting and machine myself a new bracket. As you can see from the user manual exploded view, to remove the motor, I would have to remove the couplings, pulleys, unscrew the face mountings, and there's also the electrical wiring that I had to remove as well, which wasn't too difficult. And then finally remove the L-shaped bracket that you can see in the drawing here. As you can see in this diagram, this is the original L-shaped bracket removed from the motor. What I had to do is pick up the old sensors for the fitting to the lathe bed and then fabricate myself a new face mounting. What I did find out is the type of motor mounting that I required, or what is supplied with this motor, is a B34. It bolts straight onto the face, and so I had to fabricate myself a new faceplate and weld it all up and then fit it onto the lathe. This is a box that the motor arrived in, so you can see the maker's name, the type, the model, the voltage, the frequency, the size in kilowatts, the mounting, as I mentioned before, was a B34, insulation and IP rating. Upon fitting the motor, I discovered that the shaft was short in comparison to the original motor, so therefore I had to fabricate myself a new shaft extension. I have to make an apology for the quality of this photograph. As you may have already imagined, I have already installed this new motor, so therefore I had to go back and find an equivalent photograph of the shaft extension that I had to machine up. It's a 19mm shaft extension and it works perfectly. Due to the increased size of the motor, stepping it up to 1 horsepower or 0.75 kilowatts, you will discover that the motor shaft is now 19mm in comparison to the half inch shaft that is supplied with the original motor. So therefore, you're going to need a new 19mm pulley. This one is a 5-step pulley. As you can see from this photograph, I've already installed the motor and I've offset it at 2 o'clock. The reason that I had to do this is because the size of the capacitor casing on top of the motor, there is a start capacitor and a run capacitor in there that's encased, also with the wiring. But it does fit, you've just got to offset it to 2 o'clock. As you can see from this close-up view, the motor fits snugly into the space provided. And even though I've had to offset it to 2 o'clock, I can still make it fit, and it works perfectly. When searching on the internet for a 19mm stepped pulley. The only one that I could find was a five step, and you'll see on this photograph there are 1, 2, 3, 4 grooves. I had to machine the fifth step off the pulley. As you can see, with everything fully installed, I treated myself to a new set of V drive belts. I went down to the local garage, took the existing ones that I got, and found her at the closest fit replacements. They're quite easy to get hold of, and they only cost about £4 each. After reviewing the OEM manual, the slowest speed I could get out of this chuck was 160 RPM. So therefore, after installing the new motor and new pulleys, I thought I'd take this opportunity to find out what is the slowest speed I can get out of this chuck. And as you can see, it's 170 RPM, which is not too bad, but the motor is more powerful and it's brand new.